And to find out more about the latest in solar innovations and the industry, I am now joined by Thomas Koch Blank, who is with the Rocky Mountain Institute, and you're in charge of many community solar programs, which are kind of the mid-sized programs. I first wanted to ask you, what is your opinion about the impact overall to the industry with these tariffs?
So the tariff has obviously hurt the industry in the near term here in the U.S. And you could see already last year that there was a significant holdup in decision making. So a lot of uncertainty in the market that drove postponement of projects into this year. So looking at the total installed capacity last year was a substantial drop in quarter four compared to projections.
Do you think the Chinese companies, we talked a lot about with some varying opinion, they kind of also said that it wasn't a huge deal, that they have other markets, but do you think it hurts them in any way with these?
The imports into the U.S. is only partially supplied by China. So roughly 20% of panel imports come from China. Apart from that, it comes from other Southeast Asian manufacturers in Korea and Vietnam and Japan. So And the U.S. market is in the order of 10 to 15 gigawatts per year. And in light of that, you know, the announcement from India that they're going to put out 100 gigawatts starting from 20 today, so roughly 80 gigawatts in 2 years now by 2020, is going to by far outpace the U.S. demand. And they don't have much domestic manufacturing in India. So yes, there are other markets for Chinese manufacturers.
And tell us about some of the latest trends that try to bring the solar energy costs in line with traditional fuels.
So there are really two things I see. So when you look at the actual panels, there are a lot of innovation coming online or into the market for panels now. And while costs have been coming down, the rate of innovation have been reasonably slow for panels over the last 5 to 10 years. But now you see bifacial panels coming online, you see some coating technologies, you see some really interesting step changes in terms of the productivity of the panels, which is really exciting. And the second is we see continued cost reduction in the non-panel costs, so the balance of system costs of installations. And what we think is on the horizon is, and we might already see a little bit in India and China, is more pre-assembled units. So you basically move in-field labor into more controlled environments.
And you're actually working in China too, and you have operations that tell us about those projects and what are you working on?
So the Rocky Mountain Institute has a China program where we support the Chinese government and interface with the business stakeholders to transition towards a more sustainable energy system in China. So it's all in line with the Chinese very high aspirations on sustainability and renewables.
And that's a 2030 plan, right?
Right, it's a longer term plan, but there is a 2030 milestone. So the 2030 milestone in that roadmap implies 20% energy consumption across sectors from renewables. And it requires China to really build the size of the U.S. total grid with only 100% renewables by 2030.
That's a massive goal. Are they on track to be able to achieve that?
They are. They are building out quite substantial panel capacity, but they're also putting those to work in China. So the majority of the panels manufactured in China are delivered into the domestic market where they're installing these systems to feed the electricity consumption in China.
Okay, thank you very much. That's Thomas Koch Blank from the Rocky Mountain Institute for joining us to talk about solar and the trends in China, working in China to achieve a lofty goal, which he says they are on track to attain. So that's here from the Solar Summit. Back to you now in the studio.